South Florida is home to beautiful ecosystems. But right now, they're in danger. Why, you may ask? One word, seven letters. Iguanas.
These large ones, they dig big burrows. They get real aggressive and territorial with our native species. And that's obviously what we're trying to avoid.
Meet Mike Kimmel, also known as Trapper Mike.
Wildlife and reptiles in general has always been something I've been really interested in. Even as a kid, I used to breed and sell reptiles to make allowance.
But now, Mike Kimmel is protecting our ecosystem by eliminating these iguanas one lizard at a time.
Well, elevate bullets like the Matrix.
I've learned so much from Mike. He really knows the stuff. But I've learned a lot about invasive species and how they are taking over Florida.
Taking over Florida. In 2007, a group of scientists documented 3,169 iguanas in South Florida. How many are there today? Nobody knows. What we do know, these reptiles are hurting our environment.
Definitely what they have the largest effect on is the burrowing owls and our gopher tortoise. And what they do is they actually go in their burrows, they'll go as far as to destroy a nest they have in the burrows, and then they'll lay their own nest.
The damage they're causing in our community goes beyond our native animals.
So 948 outages year to date on potentially iguanas. We receive a call of a power outage, we go and investigate, and most of the times it's an animal or an iguana that takes out the power other than weather.
Because they cause problems like this, Trapper Mike is hired across the state of Florida to remove iguanas.
The communities and golf courses that hire me, they need them gone really bad. They're not dealing with pythons, they're dealing with iguanas.
Of course, everybody wonders one thing. Green iguanas are not protected in Florida and can be humanely killed on private property with landowner permission.
So at FWC, we just actually passed a new law in April of this year. And so this law prevents people from continuing to breed and sell iguanas here in the state.
There's clearly a lot of support for the eradication of iguanas in South Florida. But of course, some people can't help but sympathize for them.
My name is Ron McGill. I'm the communications director here at Zoo Miami, and I'm basically the spokesperson for the zoo. I started here as a zookeeper, became a lead keeper, a senior keeper, zoo supervisor, assistant curator. Listen, I have real issues with just a blanket, it's okay to go out and kill iguanas, because again, this is not the iguana's fault. Having said that, I don't have a problem with iguanas being humanely dispatched. It's not the iguana's fault. So I'm kind of torn between, geez, I feel badly for the iguanas, but at the same time, I realize they don't belong here and need to be removed.
And that's where people like Trapper Mike come in.
So we got a good one up here. It looks like a big dominant male. You can tell by just how large it is and how it has some of the orange in it. Get him on. Otto's captured many iguanas that haven't been shot or, you know, that have been shot and are getting away. He'll go and grab them.
Otto, let's go.
Do you want to bring him on?
Nice work, bro.
Oh, he didn't have off.
Good boy. All right, get him.
Mike Kimmel, also known as Trapper Mike, is just one Florida resident trying to keep the ecosystem intact. And until these iguanas are successfully exterminated,
there's a good one right there.
Florida will continue to be overrun by this invasive species.
Καλημέρα, καλώς ήρθατε. Είμαι η Διονυσία, το όνομά μου είναι Ανθούλη Διονυσία. Ασχολούμαι με τη μελισσοκομεία εδώ και αρκετό καιρό. Μπήκα σε οικογένεια μελισσοκόμων και συνεχίζω την παράδοση. Λοιπόν, είμαστε τρίτης γενιάς μελισσοκόμοι. Ξεκινήσαμε με δύο κυψέλες που είχαν δώσει στον παππού τότε για να βγάλει λίγο μέλι για τα παιδιά του και από αυτές τις δύο κυψέλες τα 7 παιδιά του παππού άρχισαν να δουλεύουν με τις μέλισσες. Το ίδιο κάνουν και τα εγγόνια του, δηλαδή εμείς. Και τώρα βλέπουμε πολύ μεγάλη χαρά ότι και τα δικά μας παιδιά συνεχίζουν αυτή την παράδοση. Beekeeping is not a business for a person, it's family business. Everybody has to work, everybody has to help the one the other, as the bees do. It's not possible one person to do everything. It's too hard. As family, they have to work. Είμαστε πάνω από 100 χρόνια στον χώρο. Προσπαθούμε να κάνουμε ό,τι καλύτερο μπορούμε. Γι' αυτό και επιλέγουμε να ταξιδεύουμε και στα γύρω νησιά, τις Κυψέλες. Επισκεπτόμαστε Νήσυρο, Κάλυμνο, Τήλο, Ρόδο, αναλόγως με το τι θέλουμε να πετύχουμε. Εκείνες τις εποχές ήταν πολύ δύσκολα τα πράγματα, γιατί δεν είχαν τόσα πολλά μέσα έτσι ώστε να μεταφέρουν τις Κυψέλες όπου χρειαζότανε. Τα πάντα όλα γινόντουσαν με τα γαϊδουράκια. Οπότε οι κινήσεις τους ήταν πολύ περιορισμένες. Οπότε ήταν πολύ δύσκολη σαν δουλειά. Σιγά σιγά με την πάροδο του χρόνου όλα γίνανε λίγο πιο εύκολα για μας. Η δουλειά του βουνού εννοείται ότι είναι πολύ δύσκολη γιατί πρέπει να δουλεύεις όπως και ο παππούς μέσα στον ήλιο. As you can see, we use plenty of colors in front of the beehives just because the bees use it as antlers. Usually the bees that come out from a beehive with a red color will not go into a blue one. Okay. Αργότερα, όταν ο πατέρας μας αποφάσισε να μεταφέρει τις Κυψέλες στα γύρω νησιά, χρησιμοποιούσαν τα παραδοσιακά καΐκια. Που πάλι ήταν δύσκολο, γιατί έπρεπε να τα μεταφορτώσουν τρεις και τέσσερις φορές την ίδια Κυψέλη. Αλλά ήταν ο τρόπος που είχαν επιλέξει. Έχουμε μεγαλώσει με την ιδέα ότι ό,τι τρως, είσαι. Αν ψάξεις τα αρχαία συγγράμματα του Ιπποκράτη, του Ασκληπίου και μεγάλων γιατρών της αρχαιότητας, θα δεις ότι τα πάντα όλα σαν φάρμακο υπάρχουν γύρω μας. Λοιπόν, ένα από αυτά είναι και το μέλι. Γιατί το μέλι μπορεί να, τώρα να το βλέπει ο κόσμος σαν κάτι γλυκό, αλλά στην ουσία είναι ένας τύπος φαρμάκου. Και όχι μόνο το μέλι, αλλά και όλα τα υπόλοιπα που μπορεί να μας δώσει μία Κυψέλη. Όπως είναι η γύρη, η πρόπολη, ο βασιλικός πολιτός, ακόμα και το κερί το χρησιμοποιούμε σαν φάρμακο. Η εξέλιξη της τεχνολογίας εδώ πέρα μας έχει βοηθήσει. Λόγω της δουλειάς μας εδώ, ερχόμαστε σε επαφή με κόσμο από όλη την Ευρώπη, για να μην πω και από όλο τον κόσμο. Το πρώτο που ρωτάει ο κάθε επισκέπτης είναι αν έχουμε πρόβλημα με τη μελισσοκομεία, γιατί εκείνοι στις χώρες τους αντιμετωπίζουν συγκεκριμένα προβλήματα, όπως για παράδειγμα ότι χάνονται οι μέλισσες. Αυτή τη στιγμή, γι' αυτό το νησί που έχω άποψη, σας λέω ότι τέτοιο πρόβλημα δεν υπάρχει. Αλλά ήδη η κυβέρνησή μας, ήδη το συγκεκριμένο Υπουργείο, να το πω έτσι, έχει αρχίσει να μας κάνει ερωτήσεις. Εάν βλέπουμε διαφορές, εάν έχουμε αρχίσει να χάνουμε μέλισσες και γενικά αν υπάρχουν τύπου αρρώστιες καινούργιες. Ευτυχώς μέχρι τώρα τα πάντα όλα είναι ίδια. Καλά. Υπάρχουν οι αρρώστιες αυτές που υπήρχαν χρόνια τώρα. Δεν έχουμε κάτι καινούργιο. Γιατί να σας πω ότι αν χάσουμε τις μέλισσες, γενικά σε όλη τη γη, μετά μας απομένουν 4 χρόνια ζωής. Και αυτό δεν το λέω εγώ, το είπε ο Αϊνστάιν. Κάτι παραπάνω ξέρει. Αυτή τη στιγμή έχουμε 5 διαφορετικά είδη μελιού, αλλά αυτό δεν είναι σίγουρο ότι το έχουμε κάθε χρόνο. Αυτό, το πόσα είδη θα έχουμε εξαρτάται από τον καιρό. Το πόσο θα βοηθήσει ο καιρός.
So the population of a beehive can start from 2,000 bees. And during the summer that they have the extra floor, maybe go up to 60,000 bees. It's about the season and the weather outside.
Αυτή τη στιγμή μέσα σε αυτό το χώρο θα βρούμε μέλι από κουμαριά, μέλι από ρίκι, από πεύκο, από θυμάρι που είναι και το τυπικό μέλτισκο και από λουλούδια της άνοιξης. Τα πάντα όλα εξαρτώνται όμως από τον καιρό. Και μιλάμε με διαφορετικά ονόματα, η διαφορετική στιγμή του χρόνου συλλέγει διαφορετική γύρη με αποτέλεσμα να παίρνουμε άλλο μέλι. Και δεν είναι διαφορετικό όνομα, είναι εντελώς διαφορετική η γεύση, το άρωμα, το χρώμα, εντελώς διαφορετικά πράγματα. Υπάρχουν πολλά προϊόντα και άλλα προϊόντα τα οποία είναι εξίσου ή ίσως και ακόμα και καλύτερα από το μέλι. Από μία κυψέλη μπορούμε να πάρουμε τη γύρη που χρησιμοποιεί η μέλισσα για να φτιάξει τα πάντα. Θα πάρουμε το κερί, την πρόπολη, το βασιλικό πολτό και φυσικά το μέλι. Όλα τα χρησιμοποιούμε για την καλύτερη υγεία μας. Οπότε όλα τα προϊόντα της μέλισσας, αν ξέρεις να τα χρησιμοποιήσεις ή αν ψάξεις λίγο, γίνονται καταπληκτικά φάρμακα χωρίς χρήση χημικών. Λοιπόν, η φιλοσοφία του συγκεκριμένου μαγαζιού ήταν να δείξουμε στον κόσμο ότι δεν είναι μόνο το μέλι που θα πάρουμε από μία κυψέλη. Και νομίζω ότι αυτό ήταν που έσπρωξε τον κόσμο να πάει στη μελισσοκομεία.
For 60 years, dictators have ruled my island. I'm Cuban-American. Hell, I'm proud to be Cuban-American. But I've never even actually seen the island. Of course, my grandparents have told me stories about how great it was. But everybody tells me it's never gonna go back to what it once was. I personally think we can make a change. All we have to do is just rise up. For decades, there was little to no communication from the island. But one summer day, Cuba called for help. Cuba's cry was heard across the world, and it sparked an international movement. The heart of it? Miami, Florida.
It's an incredibly emotional experience because obviously we're seeing the images coming out of Cuba, and that obviously gives us a lot of hope that there could possibly be freedom in the country of our parents' birth and our origin.
I hope that I can be with my people in freedom again.
Vamos a decir que Gama lo va a buscar.
Lo que estamos pidiendo es libertad.
Una libertad para Cuba.
For weeks, crowds protested in front of the locally famous Cuban restaurant, Vizayas.
So it's a place where people come and congregate, where they come and protest, where they come and celebrate as you've known, like in things like Castro's death and things like that. So it's just become kind of the Cuban City Hall.
This is I'm most hopeful in any for the first time in over 60 years that something can happen in Cuba. But because these demonstrations happened in about 45 different places at the same time, it was organic, it was spontaneous, and the people are shouting, you know, for they want freedom. Young people want freedom. I think it's a very important time in Cuban history, and we need to support the Cuban people in this hour when they are shouting that really what they want is the regime to leave.
We have made a lot of progress, and I think we are in a very unique opportunity to bring about real change in Cuba.
Tony Costa and the Foundation for Human Rights in Cuba has been collaborating with Cuban producer Emilio Estefan to create a song for the movement.
Accomplice is not about the music, it's about the images. I'm gonna go worldwide and see the reality because we have internet now and we have, you know, the phones and the people be able to see exactly what has been happening in Cuba over 62 years.
A mí lo que me sorprende ver que el exilio cubano, hay personas que tienen 90 años todavía tienen la gana de seguir luchando por la libertad de nuestro país.
And everyone involved is doing their part to make a difference, even if it means going by boat for 90 miles just to show the people from Havana, Cuba, a sign of hope.
My plan is to show support for the Cuban people. You know, show them that they have a whole country behind them. They have all, not just the Cuban people, all over the world are behind freedom.
Lester, alongside other boaters, went from Key West into international waters into the territory of Havana, Cuba, while being protected by the Coast Guard. They ignited fireworks that could be seen from the island. But change isn't only in the hands of adults. Teenagers and even kids have a voice just as powerful as anyone else when it comes to this movement.
Well, I think it is extremely important for the youth to know what's happening, especially in Cuba right now. The youth is literally the future. Eventually, everyone is not going to be around, and the youth is going to be those who will be around the longest.
We are dressed not in black, but in white, because we don't want the regime to let the death of these brave martyrs be something to mourn. Their lives will not be in vain. Today, we walk in silence to remember and support the detained, missing, murdered, their families, and to denounce the deaths of Cuban youth that took the streets to scream for liberty.
The Students for a Free Cuba organized this walk in order to combat the regime and commemorate those who have lost their lives and suffered injustice in the island nation.
Today's event, we had organized a protest in Versalles, and after seeing how that turned out and after seeing the Cuban community and how they are together, we decided that it would be very significant for youth to have a presence.
And from silent protesters to Cuban-American athletes, many young people have proven to have a voice in this movement.
It's very difficult to sit back knowing how good we have it here in the United States, knowing of the people that we love, the culture we love, the country that we love, fighting for their lives on the streets. But this is not something that just needs to be swept under the rug. The light still needs to be shined on this problem.
And campaigns like Guadecide have put hope back in the hearts of many Cubans during protests like the one Alvarez describes.
Yeah, so we work with Guadecide to empower the Cuban people in order to be able to do bottom-up change in Cuba, to mobilize the people, mobilize the streets so that Cuban citizens can take their future back into their own hands.
Cuba Decide, an organization dedicated to changing the Cuban political system and reinstating democracy on the island, has gotten thousands of Cuban citizens to join its campaign. These activists have gotten the support from the European Parliament, the Inter-American Commission on Human Rights, and many more. Their efforts are heard across the globe. But change is in the hands of the people.
I mean, look, I'm Cuban, born in Cuba.
Well, my parents are both Cuban.
Soy cubano. Hace 8 años estoy aquí.
I'm a Cuban-American person.
Como todo cubano.
And with a Cuban heritage comes a love for music. Patria y Vida, Cuban musical group Gente de Zona's hit song, has become an anthem for this movement.
Cuando crecí un poquito, decía, ya viene llegando. Esa era la canción. Y ahora dicen Patria y Vida.
We want to keep the volume up.
We want to make sure that the national and international community pays attention to what's happening in Cuba, so that hopefully the Cuban government is in a place where they can no longer fool people into believing that they're not a cruel regime. And that's hopefully going to promote change in Cuba quicker.
Estos días han sido muy dolorosos para todos, pero a la vez tenemos que sentirnos orgullosos, porque ya Cuba perdió el miedo. Pueden tener el control político, pero no el control del pueblo.
For generations, real change in Cuba seems like an elusive dream. Now, change could be on the horizon, and though freedom still seems like it's a million miles away, I won't give up. And neither will the millions of people around the world who've joined the fight to free my people from a government that has kept them prisoner for more than 60 years.